English Weekly. Your English Weekly. La chronique 100% en anglais de Radio Grand Lac avec Sinead.
Ah, hello everyone and welcome back to your English Weekly. My name is Sinead Dupont and I'm hosting our 14th edition today. You know that Your English Weekly promotes English speaking on varying subjects for jobs, association, and for the English people in the English community with, of course, an expression of the week. So I hope you all had a good week and thank you all for being here today with us and thank you Radio Grand Lac 92.1 that make this show work. So today we're talking with Bridget Germana. Hello, Bridget.
Hello, Sinead.
So Bridget is coming. She's a specialist in training programs who's going to come and speak to us today about the association Butterflies. But for you people in French, you know it as Les Papillons. So this is an association that helps children who were victims of abuse and neglect. So just a quick congratulations to our winner, Corinne Gros, who had won our prize of the goodies last week, which was a boxes of chocolates and biscuits, sponsored by Charlotte. Okay, so today let's come back. Today our surprise is sponsored by Bridget. Thank you, Bridget. And it's a book called Beauty in My Plate, which talks about a beautiful attitude to have with food, with Dr. Olivier Curtin and Fabien Legrand, who does the drawings. Is that right, Bridget?
Yes, that's right.
Thanks, Bridget, for coming today.
Thanks. I'm very happy to be here today.
Okay, so before talking with Bridget about her language experience and the association of butterflies, Les Papillons, and the book Beauty in My Plate, we will go on to our expression of the week. So let's see now, Bridget, if you know what our expression of the week is. Do you know what a blessing in disguise means? Do you have any idea what that might mean?
Well, I'm not sure. I don't remember. I have probably heard it, but I never used it.
Ah, well, listen, we'll just find out at the end. So listeners, stay tuned to find out the answer to this expression, a blessing in disguise. If you think you know the answer, send me a message to Your English Weekly via Facebook. I hope I get as many messages as the others before us did, because they were hopping on their radio today, hopping their telephones were. So we'll see now who calls in today for this. Don't forget, listeners, if you wish to participate in this chronicle or you know the answer, contact us directly by the via the réseaux sociaux or the social networks. Okay, back to my guest now, Bridget. She was born in Lyon. She studied in England, worked between England, Spain and France. And she's here to speak with us today about the Association Butterflies and the fabulous book, Beauty in My Plate. Okay, Bridget, could you introduce yourself to our auditors?
I worked for 10 years in import and export. When I settled down in Savoie, I changed and I went into the training sector. I'm now working in a training center to organize lessons in English, Spanish, German, office administration tools like Excel, Word, PowerPoint. I have two children and a cat.
Oh, what's your cat's name?
Mickey.
Oh, that's so sweet. I think I actually had a cat that was called Mickey too at one stage. Oh, how wonderful. So, Bridget, we'll start with the association and the association for children called Les Papillons in French. So, can you give us a few details about this association?
It's a very new association. It's only 3 years old. However, I'm thrilled because it has more than 1,000 volunteer workers always helping children.
1,000 volunteers, no way. That's huge. In 3 years, so that's a very small association, or a very young association, I mean. That's fantastic. So what exactly do they do?
Their object is to help children to liberate their speech, their pain and sufferance due to abuse, either physically, psychologically or sexually. So what the association does is to drop letterboxes everywhere for children, for example, in schools, after school centers, and sports clubs.
Okay, sports clubs too. That's good, actually. Okay. So how did you get involved with this, Bridget? Because, I mean, you just don't... How do we find these associations?
Well, because I've got time on my hands, I decided to help them because one of my best friends is highly involved with them. She brought me in because she needed help.
Oh, of course, yeah, logically.
Her name is Laura Billa. She's the referent for Savoie and Haute-Savoie. She coordinates all the activities and local actors, who can help in her project.
Okay, so she coordinates all this with all the volunteers, etc.
Yeah.
So what exactly does the charity do? We know they drop off letterbox, because mm-hmm. you've just told us. But it must be more to it than just that, Bridget. What exactly do they do?
So they pick up the letters and drawing from the letterboxes, and they send them to professionals for advice if it's a myth or a fact.
Okay, yeah, I understand. Okay.
Then, depending on the results of the professional staff, they send them to the State Department and do the necessary to help those children.
Okay. And they're the ones, I presume, then, that just, of course, find out if it's true or false, like you've just said, and they'll decide what to do then. So why do they set up letterboxes?
Because it allows the children to liberate their voice with pictures or writings. The most important thing is if a child can release his suffering quickly, he's less damaged during adulthood.
Yeah, we hear this quite often, actually, yeah.
Therefore, releasing their pain will avoid long-term scars.
Okay, so a scar, what's it? Can you tell our auditors what a scar is in French?
Is a blessure.
Yes, exactly, a scar. So, do you know how many children they help per year, approximately? Do you have any idea? I mean, in Savoy or nationally or anything like this, do you have any figures to tell our audience?
Sinead, I don't have the exact figures. Impossible to find, because we don't know between those declared and those who haven't been reported. However, I was saddened when I read that each year 700,000 children are victims of harassment in school.
I heard about that as well. And even this weekend, there was there was a report on the television about this. Okay. So was COVID a problem with the children also?
Yes.
During confinement?
Yes. I just read that UNICEF had stated that there wasn't only abuse and neglect with children during pandemic, but some children were also starved, maltreated, and deprived of their education.
Okay. Yeah, so that is a lot. Okay, I know. So the reason you're here today to talking about them is that you need more people to help. Is that right?
Yes, that's right. Volunteers are always welcome and precious too. If you want to become a volunteer, you have our website. Okay. Our website is www.associationlespapillons.org.
Org. Okay. And if the children need help, or maybe a neighbor needs to denounce someone, well, I hope not, but it could happen, who can they contact?
They can contact us directly on the digital box via internet, or they can call 0805-802-804.
Okay, so thanks, Bridget, for all that information. It's nice. So now let's go and talk about something a little bit more cheery, like the book what's the name of the book? Beauty in My Plate. Okay, so who is it? Olivier Curtin? It's Dr. Olivier Curtin, sorry, and Fabienne Lagrande.
Yes. Olivier Curtin is a surgeon who is the director of the cosmetic group Clarins.
Oh, my favorite makeup. I love Clarins makeup.
me too. And Fabienne Legrand is the illustrator of the beautiful drawings.
Okay, well, that's nice. Oh, and they are beautiful. I'm just looking at it here in front of me, and I really do think they are very beautiful. So just tell our auditors, the person who might win this book today, what makes this book so unique?
The mix between a beauty diet and how you eat. It reflects our body and well-being.
Okay. And of course, in during times of COVID, we need a good body and we need to be in good form, etc. That's just wonderful. So, yeah, maybe I'll be looking at this, we'll be looking at this a little bit more. So, Bridget, that's just fantastic. And your English is really good. Just for info, for all our auditors, Bridget is one of our students who's studying at your English workshop. So that was great that you were able to come and talk to us today. Now, let's just ask a few questions. Where did you live abroad? I know we said earlier that you had lived in Spain, in England. Whereabouts in England were you and what were you doing in England?
I was studying English.
Ah.
Yeah, I was studying English in Luton. It's at the north of London.
Okay. Oh, yeah, near where the airport is.
Yes.
Luton Airport.
The famous airport, yeah.
Exactly. And just a little sort of a question. Where's your favorite spot? What's your favorite spot here in Savoy for going to a restaurant? Do you have a favorite restaurant or somewhere you like to eat?
There are many places.
I know.
Can I tell?
Yes.
Yeah, I like the QG in Aix-les-Bains.
Oh, I love the QG too. And so tell us, do you have any future projects coming up now, going abroad or things like that?
No, I just want to continue practicing my English because I love it.
Yeah, I know you do. And you're so good today to come and talk to us about this book and about the association. So if you could make a wish today, what would it be to help all those children? What would it be a wish if you could make a wish today?
I would like people to know them because it's important to get to know this association. And please go to the website to see the website and don't hesitate to look at it and to write.
And of course, if you know anybody who might be in need, to contact them as well, of course.
Yes.
Okay. So thank you for coming and sharing your experience. And I wish you all the best with this association. And now we're going to just have a look at our expression, a blessing in disguise. So what does that expression, blessing in disguise, mean? Haha. So something that appears terrible at first, but ends up having a good result. So for example, perhaps one of the children has been helped by the association and it was a blessing in disguise because now they're doing really well. Okay, so it's something terrible that starts out terrible but finishes up with a good result. Okay, so thank you all our listeners for listening and don't hesitate to send your suggestions or requests. And if you wish to participate in the Chronicle, your 100% English every week, go to www.yourenglishworkshop.com. If you want to re-listen to the program, you can connect or learn more about us at Radio Grand Lac 92.1. Thank you all for listening. And we'll see you next week. But before I finish, don't forget, listeners, to stay tuned. There's a few more shows coming up now today. We've got Jessica at 1 o'clock with her new tendencies and her decorations. Ooh, I can't wait to hear about that. At 5 o'clock, there's a new program, which is in partnership with the Mozzervelex and the Mary Luc Berthaud. A community for 1 hour. A community for 1 hour or an hour with a community. Okay? And then at 6:15, One Lake, One Businessman. So we'll have to see who that will be today. So thank you all for listening and I hope to see you next, or I hope to hear you next week. Bye for now.
Your English Weekly. Quickly. La chronique 100% en anglais de Radio Grand Lac avec Sinead.